Dr. Jason West is an integrative medicine physician, and he's a fourth-generation owner of the West Clinic. Doctor, thanks so much for joining us here on Need to Know.
Oh, you're certainly welcome. And by the way, it's not just your listeners that are asking this question. I'm getting asked all the time. Matter of fact, I just had a patient yesterday saying, oh my gosh, what's going to happen to us now with the flu? And my response was, well, it's good news, because everything that you're doing to reduce risk factors for the coronavirus, such as, you know, washing your hands, avoiding sick people, trying to get your immune system working, should really help you against protection of the flu.
Well, that's good news, and I would guess this was my immediate concern when this whole thing happened in February and March, was that it seemed like everything that they were telling us to do, everything we were hearing from the experts of what to do to prevent spread of COVID-19 the best that we could, was stuff that makes sense to do at all anyway. When you're feeling sick, don't come to work. When you have an opportunity to wash your hands, do it. Make sure that your hands are clean. Don't touch your face as much. It's not healthy for you or anybody that's around you. For the most part, has that message got lost in translation a little bit here in the U.S., considering how politicized a lot of the factors are in terms of preventative measures we can take with COVID-19?
Well, I think so. And I think part of it is because people are just getting so tired of this. And when you start looking at the misinformation of, you know, wear a mask, don't wear a mask. Here's the death rates in 2018 versus the death rates in 2020. And you haven't seen a real big spike on it. And then the coronavirus vaccine, it's going to take 3 years to develop. No, it's going to take 2 years to develop. No, it's going to take a year to develop. Oh, yeah, it's going to be ready next month. And so you're getting all of this misinformation, and it's really making people, one, somewhat jaded, and two, just, there's so much distrust and misinformation that I just think it's difficult for people to really understand what is the truth.
And you make a great point there. Jaded is a great word. Sometimes you just have enough of this information that I'm supposed to be doing. And we just have a mask mandate that came down yesterday here in the city of Des Moines. We'll talk about that later. But, of course, that to a lot of people is a political statement, and many people are going to adjust what they do and shop here in the city of Des Moines and the places they go in the city of Des Moines and not support those businesses because they don't believe in wearing masks wherever they go. That's a conversation that many have had for months, not just here in Iowa, but all around the world, and really here in the United States as we head toward an election. So back to the flu. The flu has been here. We get flu vaccines every year, and it's different every year. But for those people who are not quite sure why we have to get revaccinated for the flu when we're told you really aren't supposed to be able to catch a virus a second time, what can you tell them about the differences in that vaccine every year?
Well, part of it is there's so many different variations of the flu virus, and really the CDC every year is trying to do a statistical best guess of which vaccine is going to line up with which virus. And the last time I was saw the numbers, there's 1,400 different types of flu viruses, and literally they're trying to figure out, okay, is it 587, is it 319, is it 27, is it 999, and then they make a vaccine against that. But if there's a different flu virus coming into your community, then your body's going to get exposed to that flu virus. It has to have an immune response. You have to develop the antibodies. And what I'm telling people is, look, if you are doing the things that make you healthy, vitamin C, vitamin A, healthy and alive foods, getting to bed on time, movement, exercise, getting enough water, it's going to help you not only against the coronavirus, but against the yearly flu bug.
And that's obviously important as well. We're speaking with Dr. Jason West about these flu vaccinations during a pandemic. Now, what struggles would providers of the vaccine see as people maybe aren't worried about the flu as much as usual based on COVID-19 concerns, or the fact that it's an election year, or the fact that they're not willing to go out and find a flu vaccination? What other struggles do you foresee coming as we get closer to flu season?
Well, I think one is the mistrust of information that's coming out, people being jaded for what are the actual numbers, what are the death rates. What, you know, I had a friend the other day that was saying, hey, I just got tested positive for the coronavirus. And my response was, oh, my gosh, how are you feeling? And you know what he said? I feel great. I've never felt better. I don't even know how possibly I got a positive test. And that's just one example of people saying, you know what? I just don't know if I believe the numbers, not believe the numbers, and I think it's translating over into basically all aspects of healthcare. And people are just saying, I just don't know if I want to go get this into my body at this time. I think there's a lot of people that are waiting to see. And then there's so many people out there that, you know, they get a flu vaccine and then they get sick and they get it every year. And of course, the medical community tells them, well, you would have been sicker if you wouldn't have got the vaccine. But there's other people out there that say, I don't get a vaccine and I'm totally fine. And all of this information out there is this boiling pot of people trying to figure out what to do to make themselves and their families personally healthy.
So do you expect the flu vaccinations to find a way to be another political talking point by the time we get to November? Because there already was a question from some about vaccines, maybe not necessarily a flu vaccine, but vaccine versus no vaccine. And also now what we're dealing with COVID-19 and how political all of those aspects have become on both sides.
Well, I don't see it being a political statement for the flu vaccine. I don't think it's going to do that because and the flu vaccine and the flu, you know, we don't bat our eyes really at 40 or 50,000 people a year dying from the flu. We're not really batting an eye about, you know, a million people dying of tuberculosis. I think that the coronavirus has developed into a life of its own. It's developed into something really political and it's developed into something that people, they don't know what to believe. They're tired of it. Some people are being affected by it. A lot of people aren't seeing, you know, the casualties or the dead bodies around. So it's just hard for them to get really excited about it. And then you've got the political slant on top of it. And it easily has turned into a political situation.
Dr. Jason West, an integrative medicine physician. Thanks so much for joining us, sir. Thanks for the information.
Stay safe and stay healthy. And drjasonwest.com.